Hello, my name is Mike Patton. I composed the score for Crank 2. When Neveldine and Taylor first contacted me, the first thing I wanted to do was see Crank 1. So I got a copy of it, and I remember the night because I thought, I'll watch a little bit of this, go to bed. No such luck. I stayed up all night watching it. I watched it like 2-3 times in a row because it just kicked my ass, basically. Loved the way it was cut. I heard all sorts of music in my head, and I hadn't even seen a piece of the second one yet. But from what they told me, they said it's going to be the same times 1,000. Faster, more offensive, more brutal, however you want to put it. And I figured that would be right in my wheelhouse. I have a process of scribbling down a series of hieroglyphics so I can remember what my initial ideas are, and so I can go back later and execute them. And sometimes that's on paper, sometimes that's on a dictaphone, sometimes that's me driving in my car, calling my home number and singing a melody line into my answering machine. One of my weaknesses is to kind of over orchestrate things. Every band I've been in's kind of had that common thread. It's been, I hear things densely. I hear lots and lots of sound. So for me to try and strip things back, make them simple and give them some air, some breathing room, realizing that, you know, this isn't one of your records. This is not something, people may never hear this outside of the movie. So it needs to, in some way, you know, enhance the image and take a back seat. Basically, since I have taught myself this line of work, I feel like the more tools I have in my arsenal, the better I can get my ideas out there. And I've been drawn to instruments, a lot of circuit bend instruments and toys that make peculiar sounds. These are toys that, you know, anyone can play. You press a button and you let the thing go crazy. Sounds kind of random, but I have so many of these toys that I feel like I can generate all sorts of different soundscapes. I've made entire records just with some of these awful, cheap, modified instruments. In some cases, they're Fisher-Price toys. In some cases, they're, you know, $30 synthesizers, you know, built for kids, Speak and Spells. I just feel like it can give the music an extra color that you really wouldn't get from a, you know, a guitar or a piano, you know, or a viola.